Hey there, welcome back guys. This is part two in the X-Maker Joy series 3D printer. In this video, we're going to show you how to print your fish calibration. Most likely you won't have to calibrate the X-Maker Joy out of the box. It'll print, but this is a 5 to 3 minute print, which is what we want to do because the last thing you want to do is print something that takes 20 minutes and then find out that the printer may need to be calibrated. And it does say the printer might have to be, but it should work straight out of the box. So without any further ado, let's get started. Let's get you going so you can print and set up your printer. Now, in order to be able to connect to the 3D printer wirelessly, you have to have a 2.4 gigahertz internet connection. Most routers have that by default. Your main connection should, if it's a newer router, your main connection should be able to support 5 gigahertz, 2.4 gigahertz, and another version of the 5 gigahertz on the Verizon routers. But if it doesn't, you'll have to go in and create it. Otherwise, you will not, again, you will not be able to connect to the printer. And if you have trouble, who knows, maybe we'll make another video and show you guys how to create a 2.4 gigahertz internet connection. But without any further ado, let's get started. Let's print this fish and maybe even a Benchy down the line. Come. Okay, so once the app loads, you're going to select the X-Maker Joy. We're going to select continue. Make sure you press that red button in the back so the yellow lights flashing in the front is solid. After that, 2.4 gigahertz, okay? Make sure you know the passwords to your 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi connection that the printer can connect to. And it says wants to join, and once it joins, right? And it takes a couple of seconds for it to load. Once it connects, the printer configuration network is complete. You'll get that little screen. Now you won't see the printer until you backspace out of it, or either quit the app or launch it again in order to be able to see your printer. Okay, so now we're gonna push the filament through. So we have the application open, all right? So what we're gonna do is you're gonna go to printer, right? Select it, and then right here on the bottom left-hand corner where it says printer settings, okay, you're gonna click load. Okay, press load, and when you press load, see, printer is going to throw itself up, move to the right, and then maybe move down a little bit. If you look in the back, right, you should see this little mechanism start moving soon, but it's not going to move just yet, and the reason why is because the temperature has to reach 230, okay? You'll see it, and if you don't see it, you will see it as it starts to pour out of the nozzle. The nozzle is basically the tip, and don't ever touch it because it's really hot. You will burn yourself. There is a build plate here that's magnetic. A lot of times if you wait for your prints to finish, you can just take your print right off. But this build plate comes right off. It's really nice. It's convenient. Okay, see, it says loading in progress. And if you look really closely, you can see the filament starting to come out. See that? It's coming out like spaghetti. Let's see what happens if we open the door. Stop loading, which is great. So the load progress looks like it's stopped. Nope, it's still going. So what you want to do is you just press cancel. Once you see it coming out and you know there's no need for it to continue, right? So we'll just press cancel on the cancel button. In this case, I have a plastic tweezers. You probably want a metal tweezer because metal on metal is great, whereas plastic on metal, if you accidentally touch the nozzle, it will burn it, but you can just grab it from the bottom like that. See, and then it will string, but that's okay. Look, see, it's like spaghetti. Of course, some will just continue to flow. You always get the excess remnants, which is what you want to take off. The printer will take care of the rest. All right, so we just cleaned off the nozzle, it looks like. And then you don't want any remnants on there. See that little bit right there? That can cause things to clog, jam, and your worst nightmare when it comes to 3D printing will happen if your nozzle is not properly maintained. So now we're just gonna go back to the app, go to, Explore, right? And then click on Explore again. Then you click, press Printer. And you see now we have go slicing in the middle. All right, we're gonna select go slicing, and I'm gonna load something. You'll see in part three how I actually did this, but you definitely want to print a calibration file that will print in less than 20 minutes. For example, this fish. Okay, so I'm gonna select fast. And if you can print this fish, there'll be a link in the description down below, then you're pretty much
are golden to move forward and your printer doesn't need to be calibrated. Given that it's out of the box, we don't know, but it's supposed to work out of the box, but we just want to be sure by printing something fast and simple. All right, so there we go. See, it's going to upload the file and convert it really fast because we just sliced it. That is kind of cool. Maybe we can watch with the door open. I could see some exfoliage coming out. We just take that off. Remnants, remember that will cause a jam and clog, but use metal tweezers. So you can watch it print with the door open. So the door is just a little, you know, to prevent kids from actually touching it. So it looks like it's printing a line. That line you see right there is basically cleaning the tip from the remnants that I just took off, but sometimes you get some, you know, leftover and you're not sure what that is. Now we just go back to printer and then press the camera and voila, there it is. So you don't have to stand there and watch it. You can, everything can be viewed remotely while you're at the store. Maybe you went to Starbucks to get a coffee and look at that. Simply phenomenal. Look at that. Amazing. Some stringing, in case you're wondering which stringing is. Stringing is called this thing right here. See that? Like a little string. But most of all, it printed perfectly. Oh my god, this is phenomenal. Look at that. Look, you can take this off like this. It's magnetic. Wow, it comes off really easily. Unlike other build plates, we can close that door and check out our print. Check that out. Oh my god, look at this. This is a little razor, mom and dad, if you're watching. It's foolproof. Kids can't get cut, but it'll help them if they can't wait and they're so excited for their print. If you wait 10 to 15 minutes, this print will just flick right off. Okay, and look at that. Remember, it's on a raft. Okay, so the raft just helps it, you know, it's a pretty thick raft too. Just yet, so what you want to do is, see, just use this plastic, okay, to help you get your prints off. If you've seen any of my other 3D printed videos, check that out. Kind of neat, huh? It printed the fish exactly the way we wanted to. All the bones, there's the eye. So if you want to put the Leo on here with his little fish hook, right? And maybe we'll just try printing a Benchy. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Anyway, that's pretty much it for this part of the video. Kind of neat, huh? You gotta love it. And check it out in color. Look at that. As easy as 1, 2, 3, the printer is quiet. It's stealthy. You don't hear a thing. You might want to keep it in your family room because you too, even though you got it for your kids, you might be like, hey, I kind of like this thing. You know, you might want to either get one for yourself or share it so that everyone can. And you just connect from your iPad and let it print and just have to take turns. But it's amazing what you can print. The possibilities are endless, really easy to set up, no configuring, and things just pop in and out, unlike other printers that require additional tools. Of course, you might need a hex tool to take out the main nozzle point, but to take the nozzle out, you just press the button and pull it out. And that's pretty much it. This is port 2, and stay tuned for port 3. In port 3, we're going to be printing the dummy 13 and putting it together and see how it actually works. Because look, kids will soon be able to print their own toys. Say goodbye to that Christmas list, and everything will be on their wish list inside the X-Maker Joy application. We'll put this guy right back here. Kind of neat. Gotta love it. Anyway, I hope this video helped you in better understanding how to streamline the process so you can get your first print going with your X-Maker Joy 3D printer. And if you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them down below. Or ideas for other videos. Remember to like and subscribe. And I'll see you all next time.